Today we're going to talk about the lumbricals. They are a tiny muscle in your hand and they're vital for climbing. So they're connected to your flexor tendons. You have a flexor tendon called your flexor digitorum profundus on your fingertips, what allows you to do this. That tendon connects to the base of your distal phalanx. It travels down, inserts relatively to this region of your forearm, and the lumbrical actually connects to that flexor tendon. And so in each of your fingers, there's a lumbrical that's connected to each of those flexor digitorum profundus tendon. They wrap around to the backside of your fingers and don't connect to specifically bone, but this tissue called your extensor expansion. So the action of the lumbrical allows you to fully flex at this joint here, the metacarpophalange joint, and then fully extend at both your interphalange joints. So the action is full flexion here, full extension of your interphalange joints. Why are they important for climbing? Well, do deep two-finger pockets, you stick those two fingers in, and if you have weak lumbrical muscles, that can actually get strained. People will sometimes potentially rip or fully rupture your lumbricals. They're also important for slopy pinch grip position. So if I'm trying to grab something that's very wide and a little bit in a slopy position, you want to make full contact, surface contact of your fingers to that grip. So you definitely want to be able to pinch hard. You know, unlike other holds where there's like little grooves here, you can sometimes like get a nice little crimpy pinch in that angle, but for wider slopy pinch grips, lumbricals are going to be really important. They're also good for slopers too, because you want to make that full contact. So you want to get over that rock or something, make full contact. Lumbricals are also going to be important for that. To strengthen your lumbricals, I created this tool called the Piton 1.0. You want to place it at the base of your palm. Make sure the base of your fingers are contacting that hold, and then use your thumb as an opposition to pinch. So as you're pinching it, you don't want to let these fingers curl in like so. So keep your fingers as straight as possible and just hold that position. You know, just by doing this, I can start to feel like on the palm side around my knuckles, a little bit of a burning sensation. And you can even start to incorporate some wrist action like this. A lot of times when people flex here, their fingers will end up curling in. So you really want to force your fingers to stay open, right? And just do that for 30 seconds to a minute and really get a nice little burn to the lumbricals. If you don't have something like this, you can also use little dominoes, stick it in the palm of your hands, and just once again, keeping your fingers straight and applying the pressure right at the base of your finger down, and then using a thumb or something to oppose it, applying that pressure. You can also use weights like kettlebell or dumbbells, right, in the same position. You're flexing this joint here, metacarpophalange joint, and then fully extending. And just by holding this weight, you can do this for 30 seconds up to a minute. I can start to feel those lumbricals engage. If you do this for a couple months, you notice a big difference in your two-finger pocket game, sloper game, slopy pinch game while you're climbing. So hope that helped. So be on the lookout for these different videos. I'm going to try to detail information about different areas of the fingers that could get potentially injured and how to help it. Please share with everyone that may benefit from this, and see you guys later.